It hit the airwaves in 68.
This is March 15th, 1968, and now it's time for our revolutionary new experiment in radio.
It became the soundtrack for a generation.
And here, 100,000-watt station just zopping out all over the place.
And launched the careers of superstars.
Hello, Bruce Springsteen.
This is my very first time on radio. And I want to say hello to my mother who lives in California. Hi, Mom.
Now, a filmmaker wants to recreate the glory days of WBCN, and you can help.
Good evening. Tonight, we take you back to 1968. An alternative FM station, WBCN, began airing freeform radio, and a broadcasting legend was born. Now, a local filmmaker is putting together a documentary on those days, and he could actually use your help as well. But first, let's get in the Wayback Machine to the American Revolution.
This is March 15th, 1968, and now it's time for our revolutionary new experiment in radio.
When we first came here, when we first came to Boston.
The police then fired tear gas directly at ground level, shooting at people.
104, 104, BCN.
You're listening to the American Revolution, WBCN, Boston.
This time needs something that it hasn't got.
Yes.
What does it need?
You tell me that it's evolution. Well, you know.
You're listening to wonderful Bigger Than a Breadbox Radio, WBCN in Boston.
Scoopy doopy doopy doop. Bow 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 ya bow ooh ooh. Chicka boom.
A fellow by the name of Ray Reapin, who was working on the Boston Tea Party, which is a dance hall up here, wanted a radio station and found one that had lost so much money where they couldn't afford to be on the air from about 10:30 at night to about 5 o'clock in the morning. And so he said that he had a gang of people who were nice people who would like to borrow their studios during the time when they weren't selling any time. And he said that he bet that they would get some listeners and that everything would be all right. So on March 15th of 68, we came on the air and tried to explain to people who had been listening to the radio that what they were about to hear would be a little different from that, but that rock and roll was here to stay. Here, 100,000-watt station just zopping out all over the place.
In the dormitory rooms, coming out, blasting away in all the stores. You could go from one end of Boston to one end of Cambridge and not have a radio, and you could hear BCN all the way. It's so vivid to me what it was like. You just walk in and to a radio station, and there'd be all these albums, maybe 600 or 700 albums on a wall, and you could tell by the color almost of that one edge what artist it was. And we would pull these albums out, and you know, first you'd pull 4 or 5 and say, this is how I'm going to start my show, and then you'd start getting inspired along the way, and you'd say, ah, this song will go with, and you'd run up before the record ended, and you find that album, you pull it out, you go to the other turntable that was empty, and you put the record on, slap it on there, and you cue it up, and if it was in the same key, you'd let it go, and that was the magic moment.
Hello, Bruce Springsteen.
We're on the air?
Yeah, we're on the air.
Hey! all right. And this is my very first time on radio, and I want to say hello to my mother who lives in California. Hi, Mom.
Your dial is set at 104.1 FM, WBCN in Boston.
Eventually, by playing records and injecting news into it, I think that just blending it all together. You know, people say that we're a music station, and people tell us, be happier on the air. They tell the individual announcers. But I can't separate that, playing the records, from what's going on those machines in there, the newsroom. our lives reflect what's going on in the world more and more. And try to look askance or try to just play pretty music while President Nixon's ordering in troops to Cambodia cannot be done.
This is not an invasion. Here is great universities. Occupied territories.
WBCN stopped broadcasting in the summer of 2009. The call letters now belong to Mix 104.1, but you can still listen to the station online at WBCN.com and on HD radio as well. So the question is, where were you in 68? A filmmaker wants to know, and maybe you can become part of his WBCN documentary.
Pictures from a revolution. Do you have any to add?
Bill Lichtenstein began his media career at WBCN, hosting a weekly show for several years there. Since then, he's worked at ABC News and PBS and written for the Boston Globe and the Huffington Post, among other publications. And now with his company, Lichtenstein Creative Media, he wants to go back to his roots at WBCN. And Bill Lichtenstein, kind enough to join us tonight. Great to see you.
Thank you so much for having me here.
I buried the lead a little bit because you started at WBCN at what age?
Age 14.
And what were you doing then?
I started off answering what was called the listener line, where people could call with almost any question, and it was part of the interactive nature of the station. And then soon after, I was covering news stories and on the air with the weekly show.
And here you are creating a documentary, but what is and was so important about WBCN?
I think what was important about WBCN was that it was on the air at a critical time in history, in a city where there was a very large youth population. But most importantly, it wasn't an underground newspaper in the basement of some building. It sat atop, you know, at that time, the largest building in Boston, mm-hmm. and really just zopping out, as Charles Lacordaire said in the trailer, 24 hours a day. And it also gave people who had something to say a chance to become part of that conversation. So in a way, it had a very important role in a lot of what went on during that period.
And how long have you been working on this, and what was the inception, really?
Well, I've been working on it for nearly 5 years, and the inception was the fact that I thought it was an important story to see how media had helped create social and political and cultural change mm-hmm. and the role that BCN had. And for the first time in 2005 on the Internet, we began to find things that had disappeared for decades. And what we found is that although BCN had no formal archives from that era, and there aren't many around, that listeners kept material and made them available to us over the last 5 years, and we've amassed an enormous archive.
And we're showing some of the pictures that you've been able to assemble. How much have you gathered already?
50,000 photographs,
wow.
hundreds of hours of broadcasts that have been lost to the ages, Bruce Springsteen's first radio interview, old broadcasts, Duane Allman and Jerry Garcia at 2 in the morning playing acoustic guitar, these sorts of things.
But you need more, so you're looking for more. And we talked about how viewers can actually help you. One way would be to do that, but how else can they help?
Well, I think what we're involved with right now, and part of the reason I guess we're having this conversation, is there's a site that we have called kickstartwbcn.com.
Mm-hmm.
And it is part of the Kickstarter platform, which allows people to raise money by people pledging. But the important thing to know is you don't get the money. We don't get the money unless we reach our goal by a certain date. So for us, it's December 19th, and we're trying to raise $104,000. We're halfway there. There's the site. And the important thing for people to know is that this is our chance to tell the story of this period and finish the film, but we only have to December 19th to do it, and then it goes away.
So you're running out of time, and you're only about halfway there. So if people are interested, they can make donations. But also, if they have any kind of archival material, photos or audio recordings, you need those as well. And talk about just a couple more. We've got about 30 seconds of the people and the acts, the groups that came through and were really started at WBCN?
You know, so many groups, you know, I mean, what's interesting is people talk about BCN having played The Who or Led Zeppelin. It sounds like a album-oriented rock station. But in those days, they weren't getting play anywhere. And BCN knew about them because they were broadcasting from the back room of the Boston Tea Party, this local rock club. So, you know, most major bands and political figures came through the station. But, you know, at this point, the critical thing is, and again, if I could say it again, it's kickstartwbcn.com. Any donation from a dollar to $100,000 up to $10,000 will help us get to the goal. And you don't get charged until we get to the goal, but it's critical. We've got 6 days to go, and we're hoping your viewers will help.
And so many of us have a history with WBCN, so it would be nice for those of you who do to help out. Thank you very much.
Thank you
for
so
being
much
here. We appreciate it. Up next, dropping into a diner for 24 hours.